yeah, as she mentioned, this is a very personal, can you hear me?
Yeah.
It's a personal exhibition for me, the most personal exhibition I've ever given, because it is about the process of losing someone that is close to me. The gallery asked me to do an exhibition in February, and in February the coast was clear. There was no problem. Nobody was dying. Nobody was sick even. But then, so I said, yes, that would be great. And I was actually in Florida at the time. And then we came back up north in the spring, and almost immediately, my mother, it was Easter weekend, my mom came for a weekend with my brother. And she had, we didn't know it, she had a stroke. In fact, she had 20 to 30 strokes, actually, but we didn't know this at the time. She didn't lose her facial muscle. She was still in, the stuff that I had been taught to look for in somebody who had a stroke was not the stuff I saw. So, So that's what, you know, that's what precipitated this. And that was mid-April, which was the return to Canada for me. I'm a snowbird with my husband, David, and that big camera. I really didn't have, I wasn't able to paint, especially for this exhibition. I mean, I did some pieces, but I wasn't able to create a whole new body of work. But I had just, at that time, I had just started painting this Exhale series. And how, you know, it just, it's like my, the stars aligned or something, because it was like the perfect, it was the perfect series for me to get caught up with in terms of like mentally, and like it's very calming and soothing to paint these broad strokes of color, and they're, compared to some of my works, they're much more, they breathe more, you know, so it really felt very, to me, very breathy. My breathing would slow down, I would calm down as I was painting them. And I just felt, as soon as, you know, mid-April came around and we had to start talking about what paintings were coming here, I just, this was the series that I felt was the most natural to bring here. Like it just fit perfectly to me. So there are pieces from other series as well that are dotted around, and also they've done a wonderful job. I don't know if any, like that, saw a few people reading some of these. This is all what I wrote when I was in the hospital with my mother. When you're in the hospital with somebody over a long period of time, there's a lot of hours and minutes and time that goes by, and you hear everything, and especially if you are unable to have a dialogue with the people around you. I think, you know, and as an artist, you know, I started thinking, oh, I'm going to write that down. I'll just make a little drawing of this or that, or, you know, my brother would pop in, or my dad would pop in. I spent most nights on a stretcher next to my mom in her in her hospital room. So they were really kind, and they gave me bedding and whatnot. So I didn't have to sleep in a chair. They gave me, it was a an emergency stretcher. And so I spent so much time in this place that, you know, your mind wanders, and I started documenting everything. I documented the sound of her breath. I documented how her neck felt. I documented the curl, the white curl. I didn't want to forget anything, because I knew, we all knew that the end was coming. And I think probably a lot of people who've gone through loss go through this moment where you just realize that you don't want to forget those details about that person, because if you don't write them down or somehow take pictures or something, that maybe your memory might fail you, and you might forget that what may be an insignificant detail to other people that is significant to you. So I don't mean for this to be all sad, because it is sad for me, but art painting in particular is my, it's my way of kind of getting out of I'm getting out of my head in a sense, like listening to great music, and I sing really loudly in my studio, and I paint, and that is what I've been doing. And my mom died May 27th, since then I've been doing, well, there's a lot of stuff I've been doing, but I have been getting in my studio more, and I've been painting, and with a fury, and so being an artist, my mother left me a lot of art supplies as well. I've gone through all her art supplies. She didn't paint in the last couple of years, so a lot of her acrylics were dried up, and a lot of her stuff was broken or gone or whatever, just wasn't good anymore. But I've managed to find quite a bit. I mean, she was a lifelong artist. She still had stuff, as all artists do. And she left us with quite a formidable body of work, which we ended up letting people, close friends of the family and family members, choose pieces for themselves, because what are we going to do? We're all artists. We only have so much wall space, right? So, anyways, most of it was picked through. I happen to have these in the car with me, because that's what I do. I travel with this stuff now. And so I told Phoebe about it, and she said, well, you can put some out just so that we can show what your mother did. But as I said, these are not my mother's won Governor General Awards for her art. So these are not that caliber. These are the ones that are left behind. She was an excellent artist, and she's the person who inspired me to become an artist and encouraged me to be brave and to do what I do, because I thought I was going to be an insurance salesman. But she always saw through that, and she thought that I should be an artist. But I just thought that, you know, I would go where the money is. So, anyways, you know, you have these ideas when you're younger, and I was hopeless at any. My father was an insurance broker as well as being an artist, and I did some very brief summer job in his office where I just had to do some filing, and I was hopeless at it. So that didn't last long. So I guess we could do the tour. It's not a huge tour, but it's a little tour. So my mom and I, if you have the time to read the writings, I would encourage you to do that. As I said, you know, some of these, this is all acrylics. One of the things I like to do with acrylics is, I use a lot of water, and it makes it, you get these wonderful transparencies, and it's like watercolor. You can see two very different styles here. Yes, this is the same person, me. I'll get back to this piece at the end. We'll continue. We'll go through this way, I think. So, these are all very, to me, these are all very anatomical. They are about breathing and slowing down my thought process, because I can get very congested in my head in terms of thoughts. And this is truly an exercise for me of calm, right? Just trying to calm the crazy that goes on the day to day. Little did I know what was coming. So it was a good exercise before. There was the calm before the storm, in a sense, right? And there's quite a few pieces that are sort of in the same. These are all the exhale series. There is a pause. Now that was part of the writings that I did. It just all seemed to meld. I feel like somehow, I don't know. I'm not superstitious. I'm not particularly religious, but I do believe that there was something. I feel like there was something. Everything came together the right way, and it was all you know, it was all about taking time and making a pause, and breathing and relaxing. This is called All in the Plan. It is not a religious painting. It's just, to me, this is a very different piece. This is from my Intent, a series called Intent, where I did much bolder, stronger lines that are more like a solid color. There's many layers. It's just very intentional. So that's, again, it's all for life. And I started with a basic orange, with an orange wash, and then I think thicker paints over the top and over the top of that. As you can see, dotted through the exhibition, they printed out, I have a sketchbook. This is the sketchbook that I brought with me to the hospital. When I was sitting at the edge of my little cot, I would be drawing because there wasn't really a whole lot else to do. So I had reserved one page, the opening, the front page, page one of my sketchbook, which is here tonight, and we can show it to you if you want to see it. It's kind of fragile. It's also super precious to me because on the first page of that journal is this, which is my mom's last drawing that she ever did. It's her last time she signed her name. And it's hard for me to look at this because this is post-stroke. So she had about 20 to 30 strokes, they said, and then she still managed to do something. She was reluctant. I think she knew in her mind, she knew when she did it, that she didn't have full control over what she was creating. This is what she would do. This is just a small print that I have. The originals are big poppies, nice, beautiful big poppies. And she was, I think she was a very talented artist. Of course, that's subjective, but I really do, she taught art. So I have, here's the original. I had saved this opening page for her because I wanted her to be somewhat, I wasn't planning this. I wasn't planning to show it. I mean, this is just for me personally. I would do these drawings. Hard to turn the pages of this here. So some of these are not, okay, yes, this one is here. And then what I did is I scanned these all in, and then I wrote like a poem or pieces, but just thoughts and captured ideas that I had when I was sitting there in the room. It's actually, you're welcome to take a look at this book here, which is the book I put it all into. It's one of those one-time, one-off things that I wanted to put it somewhere where I could remember it, and if I wanted to share it here. I should also warn you, there's photographs in here as well, and they can be upsetting to people because I was documenting the process. There's no dead people, but there's my mother's dying processes. There are photographs of my mom in bed as she is dying. So I should just tell you right now, so if that's going to upset you, you'd probably be best not to look through it. These also, I'm going to just put this down, but this is my... this is also acrylic. As you can see, this is very different from the pieces that the Exhale series is. The Exhale series is translucent, it's very watery, like watercolors, and this is almost like a ceramic but it's poured paints. I used acrylic pouring medium to create those, so of course, put a super gloss. I felt like it was almost like a new car, like a new Ferrari, you know, those kind of colors. And there's also motion there too. I used to be a scuba diver, so I think a lot of, and I would say this is probably even true with the Exhale series, is a lot of it has that very fluid feeling
And I think it's because of those days when I worked as a scuba diver, and you drift through the currents and through and around the coral, and things bubble, and I think if you know that I did that, you see it in my artwork as well.
My family members, as I said, no detail was too small to record. There's my brother took a picture of me. My favorite spot was I actually lay down on the bed with my mom. She was here and under my arm. And my brother took pictures of that. He's also an artist, and I mean, he builds sets for movies, and he has that kind of artistic eye. Actually, everybody in our family pretty much does. So of course, we're all looking at it from the creative perspective. And I made drawings based on those photos, as well as just drawings from my head. Again, the writings. And more drawings and more writings. And this one is with joy, yes. So, this is with joy. This is how, to me, death is part of life, right? Isn't it? It's part of the circle of living, right? And we create events, we create moments so that we can share both the sorrows but also the joys. And I feel like that's really important to put out there too, because we can go down a rabbit hole too. It's very easy to do. And I think just it's really important to keep in mind the joyfulness, the love, and the support that is out there. And I think probably if you look for it, everybody has it somewhere. And more writings, and that's David actually. He's got the big camera. Just sitting, I would draw people in the, we were sitting in the room, so I had live models, if you will, right in front of me, so that's what that is. And this is coming home. Yeah, so to me it's almost like up in the clouds, she's, and we went home too. And, when she finally passed, we knew that it was coming. Our family is very pragmatic, and we just wanted it to be so that my mom wouldn't suffer, that it wouldn't be extended. And she was on this crazy cocktail of like all kinds of opioids or whatever they give you, Dilaudid or whatever. So I don't think she actually suffered. I think she was just really high when she died. And that was the best way to go. But it was, in a sense, I don't want to say relief, but when you watch somebody go through this, and then they go, and you're just like, okay, they're done. And I can go home, I can start picking up the pieces, hopefully my father will. He's not doing great right now. I had hoped he would come, but I think it's just too, it's too raw for him. So here I am with my husband. And then I have to put my glasses on to read the names, because I know they're all like breath related. This one is called Out of Breath, and the waiting is over. So it's the end of the story, almost, because actually there is one more painting. Well, there's Sweet Apple. And that one doesn't refer to breathing, but I do feel like it's
lungs.
It's about, yes, lungs, thank you. And the reason I called it Sweet Apple, to me it looks like a Macintosh apple, but there's something very, it scintillates the senses, right? Smell is the thing that we remember, supposedly, when you smell something, that is the sense that brings back the earliest memories, I'm told. So
So smell is another, you know, it's, we smell, we inhale, we breathe through our noses, and to me it was all sort of, it's related. So that crisp Macintosh apple scent, it just brings me back to my childhood. So that's what that one's about. And that's why the name is slightly different, but it really is about, again, smelling and breathing. So lastly, I wanted to bring you back to where we started in that corner, because there's one more painting that I want to talk about. This painting. And this painting is called The Big Send-Off. And this one, I need a Kleenex. My mother, as an artist, had to eat her supplies, right? So, anyways, I painted it with both of her paints and my paints. And it started off really ugly. And it took me, I actually documented the painting of this on Instagram, and so I started it with her paints, and like I said, a lot of them were gummy and dried up, and you know, she hadn't done it. She had a mild dementia for a couple years, and I think that kind of, she lost her desire to make art, actually. And she also was diagnosed with bladder cancer, but it was only stage one, you know. So she had a lot of things that were quite wrong, but not severely quite wrong, if that makes any sense. It was, like I said, the strokes that got her. But this painting I started after she died. It was the first one that I started from scratch after she died, and it is called The Big Send-Off. And I just threw on the paint, and thick paint, and it's tactile, and it reminds me of chewing gum, and it reminds me of all the things that going on in my head. This is probably closer to what goes on in my head on a day-to-day basis than that. Although I love that. This is truly an exercise in discipline for me. So this was just getting it all out, and this is my farewell to my mom. So that's it. I guess that's all I can say. And does anybody have any questions?
Are you going to be able to sell this?
Yeah. I can't keep my art.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I have way too many dresses for a house. I mean, a gallery could keep the art. So, that's it.
Yeah.
That's my story.
Thank you.
Thank you all for coming, and thanks for listening.
Thank you, everybody, so much for coming. There are drinks and refreshments. Help yourself. Claire will be around, of course, in the gallery if you'd like to chat with her personally. And enjoy. If you have any questions, myself, Phoebe, Ava are all here to help you.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Thank you. These guys did a great job, by the way.